Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Beloved, you are most welcome to God's own elect word and prayer meeting. This morning, we are here as a elect of God to study the scriptures and also pray. And I want to welcome you and I want to admonish you to listen to the end, to listen to the end, and you shall be blessed. Hallelujah. God bless you for being part of this meeting. You are blessed in Jesus' name. Today, we have another great and important topic to treat, and the topic is the unbroken yoke needs to be broken. The unbroken yoke needs to be broken. Hallelujah. We give thanks to the Lord that he has given this great chance for us to study this portion of this of the Bible. Hallelujah. Or get this knowledge concerning this topic, and you shall never regret. Hallelujah. Listening to the end. May the Lord bless you. Before then, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we give thanks to you. We bless your holy name, adore you for all that you've done for us. We are so grateful to you that you have given us this great opportunity to come to study your word. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. May you be with us, protect us, and save us from the evil plans of the wicked one. Father, Lord, give us understanding that we may be able to understand your word rightly and also apply them rightly in our lives. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you. Every work of the devil done against our meeting be nullified. And may the Lord have his own way in our meeting. In Jesus' mighty name we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. You are most welcome, Mama Colina. You are most welcome in the name of Jesus Christ. So the subject is the unbroken yoke needs to be broken. Hallelujah. Now, most many of the modern ministers of the gospel organize programs, and the purpose of this program is to break the ancestral yokes in the life of their church members. That is good, but hallelujah, in the reality, they themselves are under a heavy yoke together with their church members that is not being broken. Hallelujah. And that's what we are going to look at. It's very important. Many ministers of today organize programs. And this program, the purpose behind this program is to break the yokes of the devil in the lives of their church members. Hallelujah. But in the reality, they themselves are together with the church members, are under a heavy yoke that is leading them to destruction. And that is what we need to consider and make sure that this yoke is being broken, or is being broken, sorry, from our lives. May the Lord bless you. You are most welcome, every one of you. Mama Meg, Mama Ogu, God bless you. Gold, God bless every one of you. Hallelujah. So, we are going to look at, and it's a very important topic. I believe before we are done with it, you will be blessed. Hallelujah. The heavy yoke that upon most Christians that our pastors have failed to break, but has failed to break it, but breaking other yokes through prayer meetings and all other things, may the Lord save his children from it. Now, we are taking our first scripture from the book of Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse number 9. Very interesting scripture. It says, only take heed to yourself and diligently keep yourself, lest you forget the things your eyes have seen, and lest they depart from you all the days of your life, and teach them to your children and your grandchildren, especially concerning the day you stood before the Lord your God in Horeb, when the Lord said to me, gather the people to me, and I will let them hear my word. Hallelujah. I will let them hear my word. Then I'll let them hear my words. Yes. So that they may learn to fear me all the days they live on the earth. And that they may teach their children. Then you came near and stood at the foot of the mountain, and the mountain burned with fire to the midst of heaven, with darkness, cloud, and thick darkness. And the Lord spoke to you out of the midst of the fire. You hear the sound of the words, but saw no form. You only heard a voice. So he declared to you his covenant, which he commanded you to perform, the Ten Commandments. And he wrote them on two tablets of stone. Hallelujah. Praise the living God. Interestingly, so God came on Horeb, gave commandment to the people of Israel through Moses. Hallelujah. And the Bible says this commandment is called Ten Commandments. And that's what God had a covenant with. Hallelujah. He had a covenant with the people of Israel through this commandment. And in Horeb, on the mountain Horeb, we know that God did not only have that commandment with them. Praise the Lord. A lot of commandment attached to it. Praise the Lord. And interestingly, we learn from the book of Romans chapter 2, verse 14 to 15, that the same commandment was also written in the heart of the Gentiles. Hallelujah. And so Gentiles also had the law in their heart and unconsciously keeping that law. Praise the Lord. Yes. Now, this 10th commandment and its expansions is known as the law of Moses. It's known as the law of Moses. And the book of Malachi, chapter 4, verse 4, says, remember the law of Moses, my servant, which I commanded him in Horeb for all Israel, with the statutes and judgment. So it is this law of Moses that the people of Pharisees who believe wanted the church to keep. Hallelujah. This law of Moses that the Pharisees wanted the church to keep. Hallelujah. There is one thing that many pastors have put into the minds of people, that when we talk about the law of Moses, is talking about the law that Moses himself wrote. But these scriptures we learned give us a clear understanding that when we talk about the law of Moses, it's about the law Jesus Christ, or it's about the law that God gave to Moses on the Mount Sinai. Praise the Lord, Mount Sinai or Mount Sinai. Hallelujah. And these laws are many. Praise the Lord. In addition to the Ten Commandments. Praise the Lord. And so the people of Pharisee who believe in Jesus Christ suggested that the church should keep the law. Praise the Lord. And so we learn from the book of Acts 15:5 that but some of the sect of the Pharisees who believe rose up, saying, it is necessary to circumcise them and to command them to keep the law of Moses. And the Bible says the elders and the church gathered together to think about this issue. And as they disputed about it, Peter stood up and began to address the issue and made them to understand that through him, God gave the Gentiles Holy Spirit without differentiating them between the Jews and the Gentiles. And so when they try to now put the law on the people, they are not trying to do good. So the Bible says in the book of Acts chapter 10, it says, now why do you test God by putting a yoke on the neck of the disciples, which neither our fathers nor we were able to learn? This is the point of whatever we are learning. Hallelujah. So this 10 commandment and 8 expansions are yoke. They are heavy yoke that none of the people who received was able to keep. They are very heavy yoke that none of the people who received were able to keep. Hallelujah. Now, this is a yoke. The Ten Commandment is a yoke because it has its expansion, as I've been saying. Hallelujah. And the expansion is added to it to add up to make it, make the whole law as 613. Hallelujah. And the scripture make it clear that you can never choose one and leave the rest. When the moment you decide to choose one, hallelujah, you are obligated to go by all. So Galatians chapter 3 verse 10, it says, for as many as are of the works of the law are under the curse, for it is written, curse is everyone who does not continue in all things which are written in the books of the book of the law. So the point is this, there is a curse in the book of the law attached to the law, that whoever does not continue to do all, that person has attracted that curse. Hallelujah. And the Galatians just tried to go by the law. And Apostle Paul told them that what you have started doing, you don't understand what you have started doing. The moment you have touched one of the law, you must continue to do all. Hallelujah. Now, the point is, if, as the pastors are teaching us today, that Christ has ended some of the law and left some of it for us to keep, if that was so, then Apostle Paul will have corrected that pastors, the Lord Jesus did away with ceremonial laws and ritual laws, but it has left with the Ten Commandments and other law. Praise the Lord. But Apostle Paul made them to understand that that is not the truth. They don't have to think that some of the law are done away and some of them are not done away, so they can keep some and leave them. The moment they have taken the step to keep some of them, they have to continue to do all. Praise the Lord. So the idea that Jesus Christ did away some of the law and left some is wrong. It's not true. It's an error. Hallelujah. And so, as the law, Bible indicates, the law of Moses, there was judgment of death and curses added to it. Hallelujah. So that the people who receive it may keep it through fear. However, none of them was able to keep. Because the Bible says the law itself is the strength of sin. Praise the Lord. The strength of sin, according to the first book of Corinthians chapter 15, verse 56, is that the strength of sin, the strength of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. That's a serious sin. So the law, through the law, sin become very strong to manipulate man. Praise the Lord. That is why none of them was able to keep. Praise the Lord. How did he do it? How is it so? Bible makes us to understand that. What happened to Adam in the Garden of Eden? Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, had the same thing happened to those who received the Ten Commandments. Hallelujah. So in the book of Romans chapter 7 verse 7 downs, it says, I did not know sin, but when the law comes, the law came and said, thou shalt not covet. Then sin took advantage of the law and produced in me all manner of evil desire. And the sin deceived me and it killed me. Hallelujah. So through the law, sin was given the power to deceive man and kill man. So even the Bible make it clear in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 7 that the ministry of the Ten Commandment is the ministry of death because it brings about death. Hallelujah. And so there was a need for the Lord Jesus Christ to deliver us from the power of the law. Remember, I said the same law was written in the heart of Gentiles and none of us could keep it. And so there was a need for Jesus Christ to come and deliver us from this law. So in the book of Galatians chapter 4, verse 4, it said, but when the fullness of the time had come, God sent forth a son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as sons. That's a powerful thing that the Lord Jesus Christ came to do. How did he do it? Bible says he did it on the cross, according to Galatians chapter 3, verse 13. So Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, having been a curse for us. For it is written, curse is everyone who hangs on the tree. So the Lord Jesus Christ went on the cross, was hung on the tree, suffered purposely to redeem us from the curse. That is what the scripture says. Christ is the end of the law. Hallelujah. He ended its oppression. The work of the law ended on those who have been redeemed from the law. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So the purpose of God, Jesus Christ, be on the cross is to redeem everyone under the law, under the curse of the law, and under the law itself, and under its curse, the Lord was on the cross for our redemption. Hallelujah. So that this heavy load, this heavy curse will be taken out of us. Hallelujah. So that he will give us his own yoke, which is lighter. Hallelujah. According to the book of Matthew chapter 11, verse 28, it says, come to me, all you who labor and are heavily laden, and I will give you a rest. These people under the law was speaking to the people under the law that they are struggling. They are tired under the law because they are working hard. Praise the Lord. God said, come to me, I will give you a rest. Praise the living God. And said, take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your soul. Hallelujah. So the law was giving a rest for our soul. Praise the living God. The Bible says, hallelujah, the Sabbath and everything is just a shadow. The real rest or real Sabbath is in the Lord Jesus Christ. That is what the Lord said. Come to me, I will give rest to your soul. It's a soul resting. That is the real Sabbath. The old one is just for the flesh. Hallelujah. So resting is the real Sabbath. And so come, and I'll give you rest for your soul. It says, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Hallelujah. We give hands to the Lord for this rest. Hallelujah. So the Lord Jesus Christ came to deliver us, break that yoke of the bondage of the law from our neck, because that yoke is what is taking the children of God into eternal condemnation. Because the Bible says the yoke, that law, charges us as evil people. So that is the reason why the Lord Jesus Christ came purposely to preach about the kingdom of God, that the people should repent and come into the kingdom. Hallelujah. And come into the kingdom. Praise the Lord. So that he may deliver, he may give us a yoke that is light and hallelujah, easier to carry. Hallelujah. And this is what many people don't want it. Praise the Lord. Many pastors are breaking yokes of Satan, in quote, in the life of peoples, in their church members, and yet they themselves, they are under this yoke. They are pushed themselves under this yoke. Hallelujah. Praise the living God. And the yoke of Jesus Christ is only two commandments. Hallelujah. One is to believe in him. John chapter 6, verse 26, 28. It says, then they said to him, what shall we do that we may work the works of God? Jesus answered and said to him, this is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he sent. In him who he sent. Hallelujah. So if you believe in him that he is the Son of God, sent by the Father to redeem us from the law, Then the scripture says, you have done all the work. That is what the Bible says. Christ is the end of the law for righteousness to those who believe. The moment you believe that Christ has ended the law, he is the Son of God, and has believed, he has delivered us from the power of the law, then God said all the righteous work that you have to do for you to be considered as a righteous person, you have done it. Praise the Lord. You have done it. Hallelujah. And so God consider you as righteousness, as righteous man, and then he give his righteousness to you free of charge, because he give wisdom to the wise. So the moment you believe, God consider you as a righteous person, and he give his righteousness to you free of charge. That is the first commandment. So the first commandment from Christ Jesus, is to keep, to believe in him. That is Son of God who died on the cross to redeem you from the power of the law. Then the second commandment is to love one another. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm feeling so heavy attack on me today. I don't know. And so I'm not flowing the way I should. But we still minister. Hallelujah. Praise the living God. So, John chapter 13, verse 34, it says, a new commandment I give to you, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this all will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. So the Lord Jesus Christ took us out or redeemed us from the yoke of the law, and then brought us into his kingdom and gave us a new commandment. Hallelujah. A new commandment. Praise the Lord. And this is a new commandment he has given to us. And most Christians don't know this new commandment. They don't even, it's in the Bible we've been reading, but we don't know that it's a commandment of Christ that is going to use to judge us. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So believing in the Lord Jesus Christ and loving one another is commandment of the Lord Jesus Christ, which is a yoke that he spoke about, that it is light. Apostle John spoke about this same thing, indicating that it is, hallelujah, it is something that when we keep, God is happy with us. When we keep this commandment, God is happy with us. Hallelujah. 1 John chapter 3, verse 22. It says, and whatever we ask, we receive from him, because we keep his commandment and do those things that are pleasing in his sight. And this is his commandment, that we should believe on the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another as he gave us commandments. So these are the two commandments. When we do them, hallelujah, we make God happy. And God is so pleased with that. We're pleased with it. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And he said, when we do that, whatever we ask him, he gives to us. Praise the living God. That is wonderful thing. That is wonderful thing. Hallelujah. We give glory to the Lord. And Apostle James made us to understand that this commandment is known as the law of liberty, and is a perfect law. Remember, the old law was a commandment that could not make anything perfect. And so the Bible says this new commandment make everything perfect. So it's called a perfect law. Hallelujah. In the book of John, James chapter 1, verse 25, it says, but he who looks into the perfect law of liberty and continue in it, and is not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this one will be blessed in what he does. Here is where our blessings are. As Christians, our blessings is not in the Old Testament. Our blessings is not in the old law. So when pastors quote the old law, quoting Malachi, telling you that keep that commandment for you to be blessed, they are not doing you good. They are rather pushing you under a curse. Because right from the beginning of this scripture, the Lord said, curse is upon you because you are not paying tithe. So even that command starts with curse before the blessing comes. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And if you are not faithful in the keeping all the law, that is all. Praise the living God. So, Christians, this is where our blessings come from. It says, if we look into the perfect law of liberty and keep it, hallelujah, whatever we do, we are going to be blessed in it. Hallelujah. And there's one important thing we have to also consider. That the scripture says, God, Jesus Christ is going to judge with the law of perfect law of liberty. James, the book of James, chapter 2, verse 12. It says, so speak and so do as those who will be judged by the law of liberty. Finish. Hallelujah. This is the Lord Jesus Christ is going to judge humanity with. That is why everybody must repent from any other law and come to the law of liberty, because he's going to judge you with. Pen from the laws of Moses and come to the law of liberty. Hallelujah. Praise the living God. So as pastors of today, we organize programs with the intention of breaking an ancestral yoke and yokes of devil in the life of people. We must also consider this yoke of the law of Moses, which the scripture makes us understand that you cannot keep one and leave the rest. The law of Moses are 613, is about 613 laws. Tithe is part of it. Observation of days is part of it. And seasons is part of it. Abstinence from food is part of it. Circumcision is part of it. Hallelujah. Many others are part of it. And you cannot take one and leave one. So the people of today, Christians of today, who has only taken only the observation of day, and they left the rest, they are in trouble. Some have taken abstinence from food and left the rest, they are in trouble. Some have taken tithing and left the rest, they are in trouble. The yoke is upon them. The yoke is upon them. Hallelujah. Don't joke with it. Word of God stands forever and ever. The word of God is yea and amen. And what the scripture says, that is it. So you cannot say that you are going contrary and go as God free. No, for sure. The word of God is yea and amen. And the word of God says, Christ has ended the law for righteousness to those who believe. Hallelujah. For righteousness to those who believe. Hallelujah. So if you believe, you get the righteousness of God. If you don't believe and you keep the law, you are under a yoke. That is it. And you are not considered as a child of God. This is what I have been repeating, preaching about it. And I will not stop until I see the whole body of Christ changing. Hallelujah. So don't get fed up with me. Keep listening to it, because it is also building you. Bible said faith comes by hearing and hearing of the word of God. So when you keep hearing this, hallelujah, that old memory of keeping the law will be wiped away. Praise the Lord. And then you will be able to live by the new commandment, because that is important. When you are able to live by the new commandment, you are gone. New commandment is about believing Jesus Christ, that he has ended the law, and then keeping the love commandment, loving one another. Hallelujah. That is the new commandment given to us. And keep it, and don't let anything get you back into the law. Hallelujah. We are thanking God that this heavy yoke was also upon us, because we're also paying tithe. We're also receiving tithe. We're also observing some days as special. Seasons and years, we're observing them. And the Lord has taken us from it. Hallelujah. So we are saying, Lord, we thank you. We did many things in out of ignorance. We did many things in ignorance. But you, Lord, my God, have saved us. We appreciate what you have done for us. The knowledge, the Bible said, lack of knowledge, my people are perish. And the Lord Jesus Christ said, you shall know the truth and you shall be free. Hallelujah. You shall know the truth and you shall be free. And the people say, we are not slaves. And Jesus Christ said, as long as you keep commission, you are a slave. What caused them to commit that sin is the law. So when they get to know the truth will set them free from the law. Hallelujah. And the committing of sin that generates from their heart will cease. Hallelujah. Call mandalaba, bro yaba, lo shaba, bro yandalaba, lo yaba, bro yandilibe, le kabra yaba, lo kaba zukta ndalaba balaba, le kabra yaba, lo shandalaba balaba, ro kaba zukta ndalaba balaba. We give thanks to the Lord. We bless the name of the Lord. We worship the name of the Lord. We magnify the name of the Lord. May the Lord God of Israel, ba ya ba ba zo ta ba le ka bra ya ba lo sha ba bro ya nda la ba lo ka ba zo to nda la ba lo ka ba zo ta nda la ba le ka bra ya ba in Jesus mighty name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, some people may note or may mark me with preaching against the law, preaching against the law. Hallelujah. And so that's tomorrow, Pastor Saros will preach about the law. That's a serious foundation I'm laying for you. It doesn't matter how you try to live a righteous life. If your foundation is wrong, whatever you are doing, I can put this thing to an end. I will tell you, don't commit fornication. Don't steal. Respect your husband. Do this. Do that. Do that. Hallelujah. I see these holiness people, they teach about sex, oral sex. You should not do oral sex and all those things. They are all teaching all those things. But you know what? Praise the Lord. You can try to do all those things if you have a wrong foundation with regards to the law. Whatever good thing that you are doing is good for nothing. That is why I'm emphasizing on this thing until I get to know that millions of Christians has come to know this truth. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. My single preaching will be about that. Because I want Christians to come to understand this. That no matter how that those pastors are teaching them, don't do this, don't do that, that this and do that. Hallelujah. It does not mean anything. It doesn't mean anything. And if you have a wrong foundation, it doesn't mean anything. Get the right foundation. Get the Holy Spirit in you. Hallelujah. Be adopted through faith. Be adopted to be a son or a daughter of God through faith. And by that, the Bible says God has given birth to you, and you cannot sin because his seed is in you. As long as you don't have the seed of God in you, hallelujah, you try with your physical strength, The pastors will push you here and there to try to live a righteous life, but it will be good for nothing, because the seed of God is not in you. Get the seed in you. Get the seed in you. Then that will be okay. Hallelujah. Then from then, the righteous life. Don't can't you see that the Apostle John, yes, Apostle John wrote to one of the ladies that, you know, you don't need anybody to teach you, because the anointing that is upon you will teach you into every truth. If you really have the anointing, there are certain things nobody should tell you not to do it. Praise the Lord. You have the anointing and you are matured in the anointing. You go to church only because you want fellowship with the want to be obedient to the instruction that we don't have to stop the meetings. They said, not because necessary that you have to go for them to, you don't know something that they should teach you. No. Hallelujah. If you got anointing and you become matured, you go to church, you have the fellowship with the people only because you are obeying the instructions given to us to have fellowship with the saint. Not because you don't know anything and you have to be taught as a baby. There are baby Christians need those teachings. Don't do this, don't do that. Praise the Lord. We exhibit love. You get a point? Baby Christians need those teachings. And people have been in Christianity for 20 years, 30 years, and they are still teaching them, don't commit fornication, don't commit this, don't do this, you do this, you go to hell, do this, you go to hell, good. That's baby Christians. That's a baby. We give this milk to baby. It's milk we give to babies. Hallelujah. Komasianda brokaba lokshabe bro yandalaba leka bra yaba bokshandalaba losibo raikaba lokshabe bro yandalaba. Paul said, "You are still babies. You are still babes. I'm giving you milk." Hallelujah. And Bible doesn't want us to be babies all the time. It wants us to grow and become sons and daughters, that we may be led by the Holy Spirit. It says those who are led by the Holy Spirit are the sons of God. They are the sons. You have to be led by the Spirit, not be always turning around, doing this, doing that, doing that. Do you get it? Hallelujah. The mature Christians come to church not because they don't know something and they are come to learn. They come to church because they have to fellowship with the saint. And a pastor admonish them and bless them. That's all. Praise the Lord. Komandalaba. Bro kabasi andiliba. Bro yaba. Lo shabe. Bro yandalaba balaba. Lo kabra yaba. Bro shandalaba balaba. Le kabra yaba baba. Lo shabe. Bro yandalaba. Le kabra yaba. Lo kabazo tape. Le kabra yaba. The yoke is broken. The yoke is broken. The yoke is taken away from you. Your neck. By the Lord Jesus Christ, dying on the cross in the name of Jesus Christ. Komandelaba bro yandelaba lo kabazoktandelaba lo kabazoktaliande le kabra yaba lo kabazoktaliande le kabra yabalaba lo sokaba bazoktabe le kabra yaba lo kamazoktaliande in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray the Lord, my God, my Savior, my Redeemer, like a bazoctabe, like a brayaba, like a bazoctabe, like a bababa, like a bazoctaliande, in the name of our Lord Jesus, Christ of Nazareth, I pray the Lord, like a bazoctaliande, like a brayaba, like a bazoctaliande, like a bazoctabe, boyaba baba, like a bazoctaliande, la baba la ba, in the name of our Lord Jesus, Christ. Christ of Nazareth, I pray the Lord, my God, my Savior, my Redeemer, Lord, like a bazoctabe, like a braya balabe, like a mazoctaliande, like a bazoctabe, let the Lord, my God, like a bazoctabe, like a braya ba, like a bazoctaliande, like a braya ba, like a bazoctaliande, in the name of our Lord Jesus, Christ of Nazareth, I pray the Lord, my God, my Savior, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Hallelujah. We are praying that the Lord will give us the grace that we may be able to walk in the truth, that the yoke that the Lord has broken from us will not get ourselves entangled to it anymore. May you open them up and pray. Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus, Father, the grace to walk in the truth to God, grant that grace to us, grant that strength to us, Lord, in the name of Jesus, that we will not get ourselves entangled with the Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lo shabe bro yandalaba, lo kabazo tape, le kabra yaba, lo shabe bro kapa papa, le kabazo tape. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, pray the Lord, lo kabazo tape. Father, Lord, help us, O God, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. We are praying for our brothers and sisters out there who are still under this yoke, but their pastors are breaking other yokes in their lives. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, the pastors are breaking other yokes. They pray for them, some of them. They do deliverance and they say they are breaking yokes. They will do a billboard, a huge billboard, and say, yeah, your yokes are broken. Hallelujah. Something like that. And then at the end of the day, they themselves are under this great yoke. Hallelujah. And one interesting thing happening is that since we started the ministry, I've learned that you preach to the person agreed to whatever you are saying, that what you are saying is true. But later on, he says, I'm going to ask my pastor. This one, write the quotations for me. I'm going to ask my pastor. Praise the Lord. As you go there and then come back, you may not even see the person again. Now, the Bible makes us understand all those who are under the law are blind. All those who are under the law are blind. And so that pastor is a blind man. And somebody has opened your eyes about the truth. And you are saying you're going to ask the blind man, the blind pastor, that what he has said, you have heard is true or not. What answer do you expect that blind man to give it to you? Because he himself needs the one who opened your eyes to come and open his eyes. Praise the Lord. He's a blind person. He will give a wrong answer to you. And if you're not careful, you get back to the same blindness with him. Praise the Lord. Ko mandalaba, bro yaba, bro yandalaba, lo shabe, bro yandalaba, ro kaba. We are praying for them, that the Lord will have mercy on his children. Deliver them, every child of God, any human being that need to be delivered from this bondage of the law, from this yoke, may the Lord deliver that person. We pray for them all. May you open them up and pray. Heavenly Father, we pray for your children. Lord, my God, my Savior, my Redeemer, my Lord God of Israel, Mandeleba, Lo Shabe, Bro Yandelaba, Le Cabra Yaba, Lo Zibo, Rai Kaba Ziande, Le Cabra Yaba, Bro Shandelaba, Raikabazo kabo rotandeleba, le kabra yaba, rokabazo tondeleba, le kabra yaba, rokabazo tandeleba balaba, raikabazo tandeleba, le kabra yaba, raikabazo taliandeleba, lokabazo taliande, le kabra yaba, lokabazo tandeleba, lokabazo tandeleba. Lokababo shandalaba, rekabaza yanda. In the name of Jesus, Lord, save your children, Lord. Deliver your people, Lord. Save them from the powers of darkness. Save them, oh my God, my Savior. In the name of our Lord Jesus, Christ of Nazareth, pray the Lord, my God, my Savior, my Redeemer. Oh mandala babalaba, oh yababa zutaliande, lokabra yaba. Rai kabazo tandalaba, le kabra yaba bro yanda, le kabra yaba labe, le kabazo tandiande. Father, save your people, Lord. Deliver your people, Lord. Lord, my God, from the bondage of the Lord, by your mercy and compassion, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We are praying once again, asking the Lord's mercy to be upon us, that my God, by his mercy and compassion, may the Lord's beauty come upon us. May the Lord's glory appear to our children. May the Lord strengthen us to stay in the righteousness and holiness to the end of our life. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, may the Lord, my God, establish us in the truth. May the Lord fill us with the anointing and empower us to live by the truth. In Jesus' mighty name, may you open your mouth and pray. Father, Lord, we pray for mercy and compassion. Satisfy us with your new mercy and compassion this morning. By your new mercy and compassion, deliver our soul from going to lake of fire. Let your beauty come upon us. Let your glory appear to our children. Deliver us from every scheme of the devil. Father, Lord, set in motion against us whatever delusion of the devil against us, nullify it. Father, by your mercy and your compassion, consider our soul, Lord my God, with mercy. Consider our soul with your favor and bless us, so God, deliver us from the works of the devil. Save our life from every work of the enemy. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, pray the Lord my God, my Savior, my Redeemer. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We are praying for our brothers and sisters who have been joining us, and they have been, hallelujah, they have not been coming, that whatever is the influence of the devil, devil can tell them that, oh, you are tired of this kind of message, Lord, message, go and listen to different message, it's lying to you. Do you understand? Jesus Christ came to preach only one gospel, the kingdom, hallelujah, and he said a lot of things concerning the same kingdom. And for 3.5 years, people are listening to him and they don't get tired. And those who didn't get tired, they were blessed. Hallelujah. The same message we are preaching. We are preaching the kingdom and then also diffuse the idea of law in the minds of the people. And that's the work the Lord has sent us to do. Hallelujah. So, devil can speak into their mind that, oh, you are tired of this message. Kingdom, every day, law, every day, kingdom, every day, law. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You are not talking about any other things. Praise the Lord. Jesus Christ preached only about the kingdom. He said, this is the message I have been sent. And he preached about the kingdom. Praise the living God. Hallelujah. Some people even bring issue to him. That my brother is teaching me on our properties. And the Lord said, who told you that you have made me a judge between you people? I'm not a judge. Hallelujah. So they want their own message that Jesus Christ supposed to preach. From now, always, you don't have to be distant and that and that. And they want to listen. They want to listen to other message by Jesus Christ. My message is about the kingdom. Do you get it? So we are sent with a specific message, the kingdom, and defeating the law in the minds of the people. So don't get tired with us. We are praying that whatever the enemy has whispered into their mind to get tired with this message, may the Lord crush those things, make that voice useless, so that the Lord will draw them back to the field to be blessed with the message of the kingdom. Hallelujah. The Bible says, when message of the kingdom was preached, people pressed into the kingdom. Hallelujah. You want to enter into the kingdom, you must press into the kingdom. And before you enter into the kingdom, you must know that the law is no more on you. That is the purpose. Hallelujah. So if only the kingdom, that is the reason why you are serving God, then you are right to listen about the message of the kingdom. And then hallelujah. And the issues about the law forever in your life, so that at the end of the day, you go into the kingdom of God. That's all the reason why you are on earth. Worshiping God, right? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So we are praying for them. Whatever the enemy has pushed into their mind to get tired about the message of the kingdom. There is one sister told me, but I came to you and then I was like, every day you are talking about the kingdom. Every day you are talking about the law, kingdom, law. I said, this man doesn't have any other message to preach. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yes, we have other message, but this is what the Lord has sent us, give to us. We are breaking foundation and laid a good foundation. So that when other things, other message comes and you build on it, you have a right foundation. May the Lord bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. We are praying that the Lord God of Israel will save these people that the enemy is trying to delude by putting some idea into their mind that they should not come here or whatever. May the Lord nullify all, whatever is broken them, whatever is making them not to join us. May the Lord crush those things out of their life, because they are losing something great. May you open your mouth and pray. Father, Lord, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray. Manda, bro, shabe. We pray for our brothers and sisters on this platform that are not coming. Whatever the enemy has pushed into their mind, in all that not to come, may the Lord nullify those things. In Jesus' mighty name. Rokapa bozoktape. Likabra yapa. Lo shape bro yandalaba. Lokapa zuktane. Likabra yaba. Likabra yaba. Lokapa zuktape. Likabra yaba baba. Lokapa zuktape. Lokapa zuktaliande. Lokabra yaba. Lokapa zuktape. Likabra yaba. Lokapa zuktape. Lokapa zuktaliande. In the name of our Lord Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And there is one thing we have to understand. The reason why the Lord Jesus Christ was repeatedly preaching about the kingdom, preaching about the kingdom, preaching about the kingdom, is a means of build a faith in anyone listening to you. When you listen to one thing for a long time, it built itself in you. I'm telling you the truth. Hallelujah. It builds and it makes you strong in it, that it will be difficult for somebody to delete it from your mind. But a situation whereby you hear this message once, then you move to another message once, you move to another message once, you will not be strong in whatever faith that you are building in it. Next time somebody will come and say contrary thing, and then you believe it, because that message has not been built in you. That faith has not been building you on that particular topic. Hallelujah. So that is why many Christians are not strong in faith, because they want to listen one here and then leave and go to listen one here and give and listen one here. And at the end of the day, before they end up, they have a small faith, which they are not strong, which are not strong in them. Hallelujah. And at the end of the day, when somebody comes to say something different, off, and you are moving to different place. You move to different place. That is why they will hear one pastor or one man of God say, this man of God is powerful, and they will go there. The moment they hear another one is powerful, they will leave there, go here. Another one is because always want to hear something new. That's not Christian kind of life we have to live. Build yourself in very solid truth so that you cannot be moved up and down. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you. In Jesus' mighty name. We are praying finally that the Lord will make it impossible for us to lose the kingdom. And may the Lord avenge us on the wicked one. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Whatever accusation of the devil against us, may the Lord condemn it. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. May you open your mouth and pray. Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father, avenge us, Lord, and make it impossible for us to lose the kingdom. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, of Nazareth, I pray, the Lord. In the name of our Lord Jesus, may the Lord make it impossible for us to lose the kingdom. May the Lord make it impossible for anyone in my ministry to lose the kingdom. We are praying, Lord, my God. We are pleading with you, Lord, my God. Deliver our soul from going to lake of fire. Avenge us, O God, on the wicked one, and deliver our soul, God. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Heavenly Father, we give thanks to you. We are praying for kingdom preachers. That wherever, Lord, whatever blessing the Lord has to bless us with, so that we can move on with the gospel without any hindrance, may the Lord bless us with, in Jesus' name, spiritually and physically, financially, may the Lord bless us all, in Jesus' mighty name, so that we can move forward speedily in the name of Jesus Christ without any hindrance. May you open up and pray. Father, we pray for kingdom preachers. Lord, my God, bless every one of us. Fortify us, O God. Protect us, O God. Deliver us from the works of the devil. Weapons forced by the enemy against us. Father, let none of them prosper in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we pray, dear Lord, my God, bless us financially. Bless us in every aspect, spiritually and physically, that we may move forward without any hindrance, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Let every, Lord, my God, kind of hindrance that the enemy brings on our way, Father, Lord, my God, be nullified in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Pray the Lord in Jesus' mighty name. You are also praying for me particularly, hallelujah, that the Lord will deliver me from any attack of the enemy, hallelujah. There was a time that's not recently, about 2 weeks ago, one of the prophets said, Pastor, I saw that demonic entities, more than 1 billion, they are all rushing on somebody. And I didn't know who that person is. And the Lord gave me the grace to look into them. And then when I was looking through, I got to know that it is you that they are rushing on you. They want to finish you before anything happened. Hallelujah. Before you come to crush their kingdom, they want to finish you. Hallelujah. Yes, even this morning when I stood, I sat here, I feel a strong, heavy destiny on me. Praise the Lord. That's why I was not able to flow. I feel like the how I have to deliver. I was not able to do that. But I know whatever God does is good. Whatever God permits is good, because He knows what He's going to do. We are praying that any kind of attack that the enemy is launching against us, because this Lord thing is not easy. The moment that day, the moment the Lord through me, hallelujah, made the church know that this is thing that we don't have to keep. Because keeping the Titan commandment push you back to the law. The moment I made that statement, and one of the prophets saw that the kingdom of darkness was there was a commotion in the kingdom of God. They say the one of the secrets that we have kept from people, hallelujah, has been exposed. That's what I said. One of the secrets we have kept from the Christians has been exposed. And the Lord revealed to them that, revealed to the prophet, that the law, the Titan, has become like a, when you want to set a trap to a bed, you make a cage, a bird cage. Then you put the food that they like at the entrance of the cage. And then you put some in the cage. So the first one, they will eat what is in the entrance of the cage. And then they will see one in the inside. And when they get there, that cage will lock. You see, that the Titan has done to many Christians. The testimony concerning the Titan has been the food that the enemy has put under the in the front of the cage, the cage. And so when people get that testimony, and then they are entering into the cage, when they enter into the gate, that cage is the cage of the law, and then it's locked in. To come back is very difficult. It takes deliverance of God to take you out. That's what the devil has done. And the devil has used those things to cage a lot of Christians. Cage a lot of Christians. And the moment the Lord gave us the knowledge about that, that a Titan is also part of the law. And so whoever practices is getting himself back into the law. The moment that knowledge came, hallelujah, the kingdom of darkness was shaken, and there was a chaos in the kingdom of darkness, saying that the secret has been exposed. Hallelujah. Yes, because many Christians know that those who are keeping the Sabbath, they are under the law, and they even condemn them. They even speak against them, that those who are keeping Sabbath, they are under the law and under the law. But they don't know that they are also under the law, because of the tithe. Hallelujah. So it's a very serious secret that the devil never want anybody to know. Commandalababa. Raikaba bo shok tandiriba. Lo shabe bro yandalaba. Lo zibo raikaba ziandiriba. So you are praying for me that whatever attack that the enemy launch against me, because the Lord by his mercy revealed the truth to the church, may the Lord deliver me from it. May you come up and pray. Father, Lord, we pray to Lord, my God, my Savior, my Redeemer. Raikaba bo shandalaba, lekabra yaba, lo shabe bro yandalaba, lekabra yobo, lo shabe bro yandalaba, lekabra yaba, lo kabazo tade, lekabra yaba, lo shabe bro yandalaba, rekabazo tariande, lo shabe bro yandalaba, raikabazo tadelaba, rekabazo taliande, lekabra yaba, lekabazo tabe, lekabra yaba labe, lekabazo ton. Le cabra yaba, lo shabe bra yaba, lo cabazo tabe, lo cabra yaba, lo cabazo tandalaba, le cabra yaba, lo cabazo tabelaba, lo cabazo taliande, le cabra yaba, lo shabe bro yandalaba, le cabra yaba, lo cabazo tandalaba, lo cabazo tabe, lo cababa baba, lo cabra yaba, le cabra yaba laba, lo cabazo tandalaba, lo cabazo tabe. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Father, say, thank you for saving my life, saving your children. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. I pray and I book blessings of the Lord upon your life. May the Lord bless you and make you a blessing. May the Lord never allow you to fall from the grace. May you receive the power to live for righteousness and holiness. In Jesus' mighty name. May you never lose the kingdom. May the Lord God of Israel give you the grace to inherit the kingdom. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray for you. May the Lord prosper you as you look into the perfect law of liberty. May the Lord prosper you in every good step you take. In Jesus' name, I pray for you. Amen. God bless you. You are blessed, Mama Ogugold. God bless you, Mama Irene. God bless you, Mama Colina. Mama Angela. God richly, richly bless every one of you. Amen and amen. The announcement here is that the church in the city that we left, they need us back to go and baptize them. Hallelujah. They have got to know that the step we took is right step. You know, you people know how the Lord started with us. And yesterday I was telling the church that God, how God does his things. If we're not careful, you'll not believe what he's doing. Hallelujah. For instance, God told Moses, or God, Moses was born purposely to redeem the people of Israel. Hallelujah. But how God did it was something strange. God caused, or something happened, and Moses killed somebody. And I believe God's hand is in it. It's part of the plan. Moses killed somebody, and he was about to be. Moses was wanted. And he had to run away from Egypt. After running away from Egypt for some years, he came back with the message of God. And whoever knew the beginning of the story would disbelieve in Moses. He would say that this guy who was a murderer, who murdered somebody and then ran away, came back and he was saying something different, that God has met God. A murderer met God. Look at him. Whoever know the story from the beginning will disbelieve in what God is doing in that man. Do you get it? So mostly God used negative story to bring about great positive story. Hallelujah. Yes, mostly God uses negative story to bring about positive story. So Moses' story from the beginning was negative. But later on, God used him to do something. Hallelujah. Look about the highlight. Praise the Lord. This city. That city that was broken down. Hallelujah. That city was broken down. There was that Jericho war. Yeah, Jericho, that harlot in Jericho was a harlot. But God used him, to deliver the people. And out of that, he became part of Israelite. And out of that, Jesus Christ came from. Hallelujah. The story is negative. But the beginning of the story was negative, but end of the story was positive. You get a point here? Hallelujah. Look at what David did. David took somebody's wife, killed the husband, and took the wife. Out of that, Solomon came. To that, Jesus Christ came. Hallelujah. The beginning of the story is positive, negative, but the end result is positive. Praise the Lord. So mostly God used negative, hallelujah, story to bring about positive, which show that our God is God of possibility. So it's not about how the thing started. It's about what the thing, the message they carry and what the thing is going. The same thing, how God took us from the city. Those who know the story, because I myself, that the beginning of the story was not because of the training that we are coming. Because of whatever, because of pandemic that we are going out from the city. But God has his own plan in it. We get to the point, we got to the hiding out. The Lord told me that, remember the prophecy 20 years ago, I gave it to you. That's what I'm fulfilling. And truly, out of that, we have 40 strong people, about 40 strong people who have been trained on the field with the truth. And when they go out and preach, pastors, hallelujah, give themselves to Christ once again. Take Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Hallelujah. I'll take time to treat that topic particularly. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Do you know that man that has shown up right now? They have been disturbing me. I should give them money to promote my step, this for me. I don't have that money. But they're always disturbing me. And I'm suspecting that they are behind my videos that are not going. Praise the Lord. They are always disturbing me. I should give them money to promote my this thing for me. I should give them money. But I don't have that money. If I had money, I'll promote myself more than this. I'll go to TV stations and do all kinds of things. Do you get it? But they are disturbing me when I'm not minding them. My videos are not going. I don't know whether they are behind it. But may the Lord forgive them if they are behind it. Hallelujah. You see? So, in the mysterious way, the Lord does his things. Amen and amen. May the Lord bless you. God bless you. So, you are blessed. In Jesus' name. See you the next moment. Amen. Yes. Daddy.